Officials from the Uganda National Roads Authority interfaced with MPs over the stalled civil works for periodic maintenance of the 72-kilometer Kampala-Jinja Road. MPs raised concerns that stalled roadworks have worsened traffic congestion on Uganda's major trade highway.
The status of Kampala-Jinja Road is not new. Any serious contractor would have known that there would be traffic. You would not predict at this level. It was foreseeable, but is it because you are incompetent?
The traffic that is there is too much that it slows the economy. So it's very important that government gives priority to this road if it is looking at economic recovery. So this is one of the biggest factors.
Rehabilitation works, which started on July 21st, 2021, were meant to end on June 21st, 2023 this year. But UNRWA has extended the completion date to December 31st this year. According to the UNRWA Executive Director Allen Kajina, the delays were caused by a cocktail of factors, including COVID-19 and financial constraints.
It slowed down during the COVID period because, like everyone else, contractors were affected by COVID, UNRWA was affected by COVID. But principally, they were not able to bring in some of their materials because a lot of these materials were coming from outside. So that's number one.
The contracts have got that phrase, or maybe expansion of it, because it gives a room for disasters in case anything happens. For example, the floods, the weather, and uncertainties.
Kajina also decried heavy traffic on the Kampala-Jinja Road, saying contractors have to wait up to midnight for the traffic flow to settle before they start construction works.
We had targeted 10, but we find that even 10 o'clock it's heavy, so midnight to about 5 a.m. is when we work. Most contractors will work from 8 o'clock to 5 or to 6, but these ones are working from midnight to 5 a.m. That's why we now must find a work method that allows us to catch up with time.
However, committee members were not convinced. They said COVID-19 had become an excuse to explain away delays in project completion. MPs also believe that rehabilitation alone cannot relieve congestion on Jinja Road, that the roads need to be widened.
They should go beyond and they look at the actually, the, should I call it the width, the largeness of the roads, so that at least when cars are moving, they go one way and then bring another way.
You find roads now connecting to borders, like Masaka Mutukura Road, Jinja Road to Busia, Mombasa, what, this road of Jinja Road. All those are biggest challenges that the way our road, those roads are maintained. We need to extend even like either to have two lanes or three lanes.
Kajina committed that next year, UNRWA will be in position to commence the construction of the Kampala-Jinja Expressway, which will relieve traffic congestion on Jinja Road.
Now, we have identified the government component. We have concluded on the documentation that will put out for bidding, and the request for proposal, that is the document that is due to go out, I believe, before the end of this year. I'm not very sure about the time frame. Then when that is done, when a request for proposal is done, then we'll go into the evaluation of the bids. And when we finish the evaluation of the bids, then we shall award the contract.
The committee, chaired by the Mukono Municipality MP Betty Namboze, queried UNRWA on how they procured energy project Nisco Granja AD to rehabilitate the road, yet it was blacklisted by the World Bank over bribery claims.
As evidenced by the World Bank blacklisting, was overcome by the company, and that now they were better than any other company to be trusted with a load of the status and importance of Kampala-Jinja Highway, involving 82 billion shillings, Ugandan money. And whether this is not one of the reasons why we are witnessing delays and visible, should they.
The The committee is set to inspect construction works on Jinja Road on Monday next week. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.